Just another book haul. What else is new?
Hey guys, it's Sarah, and today I have a very special book haul for you. These are all the books that I purchased when we went on our BookTube Besties trip to North Carolina at the end of October. I met up with Lindsay from Lindsay's Little Library, Krista from Books and Jams, and Amanda from The Curly Reader, and we had a wonderful, just bookish weekend all together, and we were finally all meeting in person. We have been friends for years, so it was a long time in the making, and it was phenomenal. Hands down, the best time I've had in a really long time. And obviously, we went book shopping. We scouted out all the little bookstores, the used bookstores, the new bookstores, the independent bookstores, all that good stuff. We scouted out a whole bunch of different options for us to go book shopping. And so I'm going to haul everything we got from that trip. And if you want to check out the other ladies, please do. I'll leave all their channels linked down below. They all have book hauls going up today as well. So we are all today sharing what we picked up in North Carolina. And then if you go back a little bit on each channel as well, we have fun collaboration videos that we did while we were there at the cabin and just kind of out and about and stuff. All four of us have different videos. They're all different, which is a lot of fun. There's a vlog, there is a blind book with a date, there is a challenge, and there's a fun game. So a little bit of variety there, but make sure you go check out everybody. And let's get into what I purchased. I'm gonna go kind of in order of where we shopped. First place that we stopped at was a little independent bookstore, and it was called Joy of Books, and it was in downtown Hendersonville, which is close to where we were staying. And it was a really cute, smaller bookstore, but they had a lot of books. I was actually really impressed with how many books that they had and how many newer options they had. And we took our time scanning the shelves and everything. All four of us bought something there. And I even gave a book recommendation to somebody. That was a lot of fun. She asked me for recommendations for kind of spooky, scary book. And she seemed really happy. So that was fun. But the one that I ended up picking up at this bookstore is a Ruth Ware book. And that is The Death of Mrs. Westaway. This is one book by Ruth Ware that I hear really good things about. I feel like this one and The Turn of the Key get the most praise. And even people who haven't liked her previous books like both of these. I already have The Turn of the Key, so I wanted to grab this one too because I'm not ready to give up on Ruth Ware. I have read The Lion Game and gave it 3 stars. I DNF'd The Woman in Cabin 10. So she's still kind of an author that I'm not ready to give up on yet, but I need to read more, definitely. So this one will be up as well as The Turn of the Key, but I went ahead and picked this one up at Joy of Books. And then we hit the mother load, you guys. We found this bookstore by just Googling bookstores near us. And this one was in a warehouse off the side of the highway. And we were kind of making jokes like, super sketchy, let's go. But this place is incredible. I mean, it's literally a little warehouse full of books. And I mean, we could have spent hours and hours there. We could have spent a lot more time than we did. And this one is really unique in that it's all used books, so it's all donations. And when people drop off their donations, they can choose a charity that they want their proceeds when their books are purchased to go to. It's incredible. I don't know how they keep that all straight, but it's amazing. And even up along the top of all around the warehouse, there would be signs of what charities have been sponsored. And it's just incredible. She said their number one choice is St. Jude. That's the one that usually gets the most donations, but I mean, they've donated over $200,000 to charity, and it is just incredible. And so we were more than happy to spend a lot of time there and buy a lot of books, and we sure did. So I have a nice stack of books that I purchased from there. And the really good thing about this bookstore was they were so cheap, you guys. And I'll tell you the prices of these books as I show them to you because they're still on there. It's just, we were shocked at how cheap the books were and in what great condition they were. And we were all really sad that we didn't live closer to be able to go to this bookstore more often. And we even talked about trying to go back another time before we left, but the hours didn't work out for us, unfortunately, based on what other things we were doing. But it was incredible, like hands down, the greatest find of our entire trip. Okay, the first one that I grabbed is Still Life by Louise Penny. This is the first book in her Armand Gamache, is that how you say his name? Armand Gamache. I have to get used to that. This is a detective series, and I have heard such incredible things about it. People who love the series are just diehard in love with it, and Krista loves this series. And so I've been interested in maybe trying to give it a try. And when I saw a bunch of Louise Penny books, I asked her, it's like, what's number one? And she said, Still Life. And I'm like, got it. So I got this one for $3.98, you guys, and it's in perfect condition. Like, there's nothing wrong with this. It's a nice little paperback. So I'm going to give it a shot and see what I think and see if I want to end up collecting the books over time. I'm not 100% sure yet. I'm not going to buy any more until I read the first one. But it's definitely a series that I have been very interested in just because of all the praise I've heard for it. The next one that I picked up is Wolf Hall, and this is by Hilary Mantel. This one I got for $2, you guys. $2 for this nice, thick, like heavy, kind of heavy paperback. So couldn't pass this one up either. This is a Tudor's book following Thomas Cromwell and kind of his life while he was involved with Henry VIII and Anne Boleyn, kind of that whole time period and his role that he played in that. I've heard amazing things about this book in particular. And the Tudors era is definitely something I'm interested in. I haven't gotten into like Philippa Gregory or anything like that quite yet. I do have a couple of her books, but I haven't read them yet. So I haven't really read anything set in the Tudors era, but that TV show, The Tudors, was perfect. So I'm definitely interested in reading some fiction about that. And so I think I would definitely be drawn to this one. And this next one is the first one that I picked up. I saw it and I was like, oh my gosh, mine. Ninth House by Leigh Bardugo. This is a dark academia book, and I definitely want to read more of Leigh Bardugo's work because I did read the Shadow and Bone trilogy and absolutely enjoyed so much of it. And so I knew that I wanted to get more into her stuff, and I knew that this was one that I was interested in as well. And then I saw the paperback and I got it for $4.98. Yes, please. And again, it's like perfect condition. There's a little bit of wear on the spine right here. Like, it's definitely been read, but that's fine. So, yeah, but this is like dark academia set at Yale. There's some magic stuff happening. I think it's like secret society type stuff as well. So definitely in my wheelhouse here. The next one I grabbed is a Kristen Hanna, and this is one that I have had on my list for a while that I knew I wanted to pick up at some point. I got this for $2.48, and that's Homefront. And this one really interests me because it's a military story, and it follows a marriage that is starting to fall apart a little bit at the seams, and the wife is a military member and the husband is a defense attorney. They have two children, and they end up like, you're kind of seeing their marriage start to fall apart. And then she gets sent on a deployment, which definitely complicates things because she's gone and away and he's, you know, at home with the kids trying to juggle life and trying to figure all this stuff out. And, you know, obviously communication is really hard on deployments. You don't necessarily get to talk to your spouse every single day or at the times that are convenient for you. So it makes communication really hard as well. So I'm sure that's going to throw a wrench into here. But that premise really stuck out to me because being a military spouse myself, I understand that. I understand the struggles and the complications with that. So I think this one is really going to speak to me. Another one I got for $2.48, Just Mercy by Brian Stevenson. Krista literally took this off the shelves and put it in my pile as I was walking around. She was like, here. I was like, okay. So Krista actually sent me The Sun Does Shine by Anthony Ray Hinton. I read that and it is phenomenal. I really, really loved it. And that one followed one of Brian Stevenson's clients, and he was wrongfully imprisoned for a murder that he did not commit, and he was released off death row after working with Brian. Brian was able to be one of the people to help him get off death row and to get him free because he didn't do this crime. And that's what Brian Stevenson does. He works with clients who are on death row or who are wrongfully imprisoned and trying to get them more justice and trying to, if not just get them off death row, to get them released if they need to be released, if they really didn't do these crimes. So I think that is so wonderful. And he is definitely a big, you know, person who was working in our legal system to get people the justice that they deserve. So I'm excited to read this, and I will do that at some point. Then I found this book, and this is one that I've been talking to with my friend Audrey over at Chapter and Converse, and she has talked about this book recently. And when we were talking about it, I was like, I've never read that. I've seen the movie, and the movie is phenomenal. Still to this day, that movie is phenomenal. But I've never read the book, and I was really interested in it, and I just had never picked it up. And she was like, oh my gosh, you have to read it. It's such a great book. And that is A Time to Kill by John Grisham. And I found a hardcover, you guys. Like, what? This is a hardcover, and it's perfect. I paid $4 for this. Like, I can't even. There's a little bit of yellowing, I would say, like on the flaps of the tops here. So like this has been sitting on someone's shelf for quite a long time. I will say that, but otherwise it's perfect. I was shocked. And when I saw it, I went ahead and grabbed it because I've been talking about it recently. So why not? So I'm excited to actually read the book and kind of revisit that whole story. Okay, so those are the books that I purchased. Now, also at Books for Good, they had this deal where you could buy a box of books for $6 and you only see the top layer. They wrap it with plastic wrap so you can't like dig through it. And so we thought we'd take a chance on that. Why not? And one of the girls bought a $6 box of books. And so we took it back to our cabin and we went through it and we all kind of picked out things that we wanted. And then the rest of them we donated, and I'll talk about that again in a little bit, but I grabbed two out of that box, and these are two books I've never heard of. So the first one is The Golden Tulip, and this is by Rosalind Laker. So this book is set in Amsterdam, and it's actually a historical fiction set in Amsterdam, and we are following a girl who works with her father, and she is also starting to form a relationship with a florist. And there are some things I think that are happening with the Amsterdam government, and her father ends up fleeing, I think, and he leaves her instructions upon his departure, and basically she needs to take over what he's doing. However, she doing that is going to cause her to compromise her ideals, I think. And all the while has this relationship going on with this florist, and he actually is planting tulips. And I think this is when the tulip kind of phenomenon happened in the Netherlands. And I was actually born in the Netherlands. So I've been there. I've been to tulip farms. They're incredibly amazing. Tulips are still to this day my favorite flower. But I think that's when the popularity really started blooming, if you will. And so we're kind of following that timeline. And so I think she's going to have some struggles with dealing with all this stuff happening all at once. So I thought it sounded interesting and, you know, definitely a connection with me and being born in the Netherlands and having lived there before. I think I can definitely relate to this one. And the last one that I grabbed from that box is Pictures of You, and this is by Caroline Levitt. Now, this one follows two women who are both running away literally from their marriages. They get in their cars and they are running away from their husbands for different reasons. And they actually get into a car accident with the other on a foggy highway, and only one survives. So the survivor is left dealing with not only the aftermath with her own family, but also with the grieving husband and child of the woman who died. And so I think all of these lives are going to be intersecting and things are going to be happening from there. So it sounded kind of interesting. All right. So from there, we went into downtown Asheville, and the one bookstore that we knew we were going to hit was Malaprops. And this is in downtown. It is an independent bookstore. It's pretty big. It was very, very crowded in there. And the reason we went into that store is because we wanted to do the blind date with a book that they offer. And I had seen that on Instagram. Someone that I follow on Instagram had posted about that at that particular bookstore. And I was like, oh, we're going to Asheville. We should make this a thing. And that's how the video idea came up with the blind date with the book that we did, which is on my channel. And we ended up buying each other books from that option. We picked names and we bought each other books and we set each other up on blind dates with books. And then we exchanged them and opened them, and it was so much fun. So the book that I got was from Krista, and she got me The Thinking Woman's Guide to Real Magic by Emily Croy Barker. So this book follows a girl who accidentally walks into another realm. She is at a wedding and she is just kind of wandering off by herself, not really feeling all that great. And then as she keeps walking, she realizes everything around her is changing and she's in this completely new world and she has no idea what's going on. And from there, she meets new people. She learns things about this world. She discovers that magic is a real thing. She discovers that there's some evil things happening, and the only way for her to survive in this world and to keep her own world safe is to learn magic herself. So if this doesn't have my name written all over it, I don't know what else does. This is the first book in a series as well. Book number two is out. So yeah, I definitely want to read this. And Krista hit the nail on the head with this one. Then we hit another bookstore called Downtown Books and News. And I actually ended up finding a book here. As we were walking around, I didn't think I was going to find anything. It was a lot of things I'd never heard of before or just wasn't interested in. But then I found a gem. And I got The Editor by Stephen Rowley. Now, I have heard about this book before and knew that it was something I was going to be interested in. And Stephen Rowley is an author I have not read from yet. I do have another one of his books on my shelves, and there have been a couple that I've seen that I'm interested in. I just haven't picked them up yet. This was one of them. And this is kind of a historical fiction, but it's a little bit of a play on Jackie Kennedy. So this follows an author, and this is set in the 1990s, and he has written a very, I guess, funny memoir that is documenting a dysfunctional relationship within his family. And it's an unfinished memoir, so he hasn't finished it yet, but he ends up querying it and it gets picked up by a publisher. And that the editor that is working with this publisher reaches out to him and, you know, offers him a book deal basically. And he's very excited and he goes to meet her, and it's Jackie Kennedy. So she's the editor that he's going to be working with. And in forming this relationship with her and working with her, he really struggles to finish his memoir, and she's trying to encourage him to do that. And like, here's why, and all these things. So this sounds so interesting to me. Sounds a little quirky, and I'm definitely excited to read it. And then we were driving around and saw Goodwill and circled back and decided to go book shopping at Goodwill. And I found two books there. I was actually kind of surprised. So the first one I found was Orphan Monster Spy by Matt Killeen. This one's a young girl named Sarah, and this is set in 1939 in Germany. And Sarah is Jewish, so she is running from the government, literally, because her mother was shot at a checkpoint, and so she is literally on the run for her life. She finds a man who needs somebody like her to help him infiltrate a boarding school for girls and to spy on them and to, you know, get the secrets that are happening there so they can shut this thing down. And so she gets sent in to do that because she's able to be able to do that. So sounds interesting. Okay, the next one that I found at Goodwill is Counting by Sevens. This is by Holly Goldberg Sloan. This follows a young girl named Willow, and she's different from everybody else. And that's all I can really figure out. The description and the synopsis is incredibly vague. The tagline on here is, if you're lost, you might need to swim against the tide. So I think it's her discovering who she really is against all odds and against what other people are saying to her. But it's like, it doesn't really give you a synopsis, to be honest. It gives you seven reasons to read this book and a little bit about Willow. So I think it's just going to be something like that. But I've heard really good things about it, so I picked it up. And last but not least, with the book box that we got at Books for Good, anything that we didn't want, we ended up driving around and finding free little libraries, and we donated them to those free little libraries. So we stuffed a few, definitely. And so I ended up finding three books at those free little libraries that I grabbed. And, you know, like I said, every single one, even if we didn't take anything from them, we stuffed them with some books. So the rest of those books got donated. But at one of them, I found The Leavers, and this is by Lisa Coe. So this one follows the disappearance of an undocumented Chinese woman. Her name is Polly. She works at a nail salon and she goes to work one day and she never comes back home. And nobody knows what has happened to her. There's no communication from her at all. They're trying to find her. They can't find her anywhere. She has a young son. His name is Deming. And Deming gets adopted by a white family and moved out of the Bronx, which is where he was living with his mother. And so you're going to see him acclimate to that. They also change his name. And but all the while, everyone's still trying to find Polly, and especially Deming. He's trying to find out what happened to his mother and if he can ever find her. And you go between Deming's perspective and Polly's perspective. So I think throughout the book, you're going to find out where she is and what's happening. But it sounded interesting. I've definitely heard of it. So I picked it up for free. Then at one of them, I found The Soulmate Equation by Christina Lauren. I have this on my Kindle already. I did get it from NetGalley, but I definitely wanted a copy of it as well. I haven't read it yet, but I love Christina Lauren. They are one of my favorite author writing duos, author in general. I love all their books, so I definitely want to read this one for sure and to have a copy of it on my shelves. This follows a dating app that is trying to get launched off the ground, from what I'm understanding. And we follow a woman who is approached to give this a try, and she's given some incentive. She is a single mother. She is struggling to make ends meet, and she is offered a very handsomely paid opportunity to try out this dating app and actually date the person that she is matched up with, and to kind of boost up the sales and to give it a good name and spread the good word for this dating app. She ends up getting matched with the creator of the dating app, and I do not believe they hit it off in the beginning. So, but she's going to stick with it because she needs the money. It sounds adorable. I can't wait. Last one is one that we found in a free little library, and it's so funny because Lindsay picked it up, or somebody picked it up for Lindsay. Lindsay was like, grab that one. And so someone grabbed it. And when we got back to the cabin and we were kind of going through things, I thought Lindsay grabbed it for herself. And it's because I had heard her talking about this book and how someone in her own book club recommended it. And so she was interested in reading it. However, she already owns this book. She bought it herself. So she didn't have a copy of it. She grabbed it so that one of us could take it. And when we were kind of reading the premise of it, Kristen and Amanda were like, this is a Sarah book. Give it to Sarah. So I got it. And that is Dear Miss Metropolitan by Carolyn Farrell. Now, this one follows the discovery of a house of horrors, if you will, where there are three women who have been held in captivity there, and they are discovered and found and rescued. However, only two of the girls are there of the three that were held in captivity. So the third girl is missing. Nobody knows where she is. And the interesting thing about this is that one of the people who lives in this neighborhood is someone who is named Miss Metropolitan, and she runs a column in a newspaper. And so I think the question starts becoming, you know, as she's starting to cover the story, because she has a personal connection to it, it happened right next to her. The questions start coming up of, if you're so in tune to what's going on around you as a columnist, how did you not know this was happening? And I think it starts to question, how do we not know that these things are going on? Are we so self-absorbed that we're not paying attention to actually what's going on around us? And were there clues that you could have picked up on that we could have saved these girls earlier? Where is this third girl? You know, that's all happening at the same time as well. This 100% has my name written all over it. So I'm really glad that Lindsay screamed, grab that book while we were looking through the free little library. But yeah, so I'm super excited that I found this one. Okay, guys, that's it. I came home with 16 books from North Carolina, but got some really good deals and not even mad about it. I'm very excited for all of these. It was a fantastic trip. If you guys are in the Asheville, North Carolina area, I highly recommend any one of these bookstores that we hit, especially if you want to take a little bit of a venture out of Asheville, go to Books for Good. It is a perfect place for readers and book lovers, and it's such a great company. We were really, really happy to support them. So let me know if you guys have read any of these, and yeah, okay, that's going to be it. So make sure you go check out the other ladies, check out their book hauls, and they're going to be telling you everything that they bought at all these same bookstores as well. And I will see you guys again soon. Hope you have a great day. Bye.